Hello everyone, I am Parthesh Parekh. I am physics teacher in NP Savani group of school. Today we are going to start chapter number 2, that is electric potential and capacitance. Okay, so from the chapter's heading, the questions arises in our mind, that is, what is electric potential and what is capacitance? So we see one by one what is the concept of this electric potential and capacitance. Okay, so electric potential is the amount of work needed to move unit charge reference point to certain point. In electric field, without any produced acceleration, is against to the electric field. Okay, so the amount of work needed to move unit charge reference point to certain points in electric field or against electric field, against electric field without produce any acceleration, so that is called electric potential. Okay, then the symbol of electric potential is capital V, and that is a scalar quantity, so we are not taking here any vector. Okay, and the difference is that the electric field and electric potential are, the electric potential are scalar quantity and electric field are vector quantity. Okay, and the capacitance is the ability of a system to store electric charge. Okay. Now we revise again that what is electric potential. So that is the amount of work needed to move unit charge reference point to a certain point in electric field or against electric field without produce any acceleration, so that is called electric potential. And another thing is that is capacitance. So capacitance is the ability of a system to store an electric charge. So electric charge is denoted by capital Q, and capacitor, the symbol of the capacitance, or it is denoted by capital C. Okay, so please write down these two things. Okay, now we see the concept of potential difference and electric potential. So let us first of all, what is the concept, let us see. So first of all, we have one charge that is located at some point, suppose O. Okay, so it is produced electric field radially outward. So suppose in this electric field we have assume two points, that is A and B. Okay, now we have take another charge Q naught, that is the test charge. So test charge Q naught is moved from A to B, that is against the electric field produced from Q plus Q charges. Okay, so when a test charge Q naught is moved from A to B against the electric field produced of plus Q charges, it is a repulsive force exerted by the charge plus Q. Okay, when we calculate the potential difference between the point A and B, between A and B written by the equation VB minus VA is equal to WAB upon Q. Okay, so here from the equation we can see that the potential difference between two points in an electric field, say A and B, may be defined as the amount of work done in moving a unit positive charge from one point to other against the electrostatic force. Okay, so the SI unit of the potential difference, that is 1 volt, is equal to 1 joule per 1 coulomb. That is joule per coulomb, SI unit of potential difference. Okay, please write down. Now suppose we assume that the point A is lies as an infinity. Okay, so here we take A equals to infinity. So at the infinity point, the potential difference, it is 0. So VA equals to 0. Now we put the value of 0 in this equation. So we get V equals to VB minus 0, because VA equals to 0 from this equation. So W upon Q naught. So we conclude from this equation, that is the amount of work done in a moving test charge Q naught from infinity to point B, and VB refers to the potential difference at B. Okay, so electric potential is work done divided by charge. Okay, now we talk about the next topic. It is electric potential due to a point charge. Now we can derive an expression for the electric potential. Okay, so electric potential due to a point charge, consider a positive point charge Q placed at the origin. It is produced electric field radially outward. Okay, so we wish to calculate the electric potential at a point P at a distance R from it. Wish to calculate the electric potential at point P at distance from O. Point P, the distance from O is suppose R. Okay, now we wish to calculate the electric potential at point P. It is distance from the origin, it is R. Okay, now it is shown in figure. The electric potential at point P will be equal to the amount of work done in bringing a unit positive charge from infinity to point P. From infinity to point P. So suppose here we take the test charge Q naught, it is placed at point, suppose some point it is A. We placed Q naught charge at some point, it is A. Okay, and it is the distance x from the O. It is distance x from the O. Okay, by the Coulomb's law, the electrostatic force acting on charge Q naught, F equals to K Q Q naught upon R. R square, no R square, it is X square. Okay, so here we have this, it is X square. Okay, so distance between the two charges, it is X, that's why. Okay, or K is nothing but it is dielectric constant. So the force F,
where F is vector quantity, so we can write here
F vector. So the force F acts away from the charge Q, the small work done in moving test charge Q naught from A to B through a small displacement dx. Now suppose the charge move from A to suppose B, small displacement. Okay, so it is move like small displacement, that is dx. Okay, from A to B against the electrostatic force. See, the force direction is this way, and the charge Q naught charge move from A to B, it is against the electric force or electric field. Okay, so dW, small amount of work done, okay, because it is going to not A to P, it is just small displacement. Okay, so dW is equal to F into small displacement, it is F into dx. Okay, the angle between force and the small displacement is, see, the force displacement in this way, and amount of force acting on Q naught, it is this direction. So both are opposite to each other. So the angle between, that is 180 degree. Okay, now we take here magnitude. Sorry, F into dx cos theta. F into dx cos theta. So here we put the value of the theta, that is 180 degree. Theta equals to 180 degree. Angle between acting electric force on charge Q naught due to positive charge plus Q. Okay, so the angle between acting electric force on charge Q naught due to Q naught and the displacement from A to B, okay. So here we can put the value cos 180 degree. We know the what is the value of cos 180 degree, that is minus. So here finally we get the answer, that is dW, it is minus F into Tx. Now here the total work done in moving the charge Q naught from infinity to point P, that is W equals to integration of dW. So we know the value of dW, that is minus F into dx. Okay, now here we taking the limit, because we are going to infinity, so we are coming to infinity to point P. So the distance between O and P, that is R. So we are here put the limit infinity to point P, so that is R. Okay, so now we put the value of F. We know the value of F, it is electrostatic force because of plus Q charge on Q naught. Okay, so we put the value, so that is zero. So infinity to R, and F is K Q into Q naught upon x square. Okay, and dx, x is, sorry, minus is outside, we write outside. Okay, so finally we get the value, that is minus k q q naught integration infinity to r 1 upon x square into dx. Okay, so we can write this way also, Q Q naught infinity to R x raised to minus 2 dx, because it is going to upward, so we can write x is to minus 2. Now we integrate this term using this identity. Okay, so we know the identity, that is x is to n dx. So that is x is to n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus c. Okay, so here we use this identity. So that is x raised to minus 2 plus 1 divided by minus 2 plus 1 infinity to r. Now we take the limit, that is x raised to minus 1 divided by minus 1 0 to r. Okay, and here minus 1 minus 1, that is going to be plus. So finally we get k q naught. Now we are taking upper limit minus lower limit, so here it is x is to minus 1, so we can write x is to 1 upon x. Okay, so finally we can write k q q naught 1 upon r minus 1 upon infinity, that is going to be 0. k q q naught 1 upon r minus 1, here 1 upon infinity is going to be 0. So we can get the answer, that is our final work done from the charge point infinity point to point P. Okay, so from this equation we conclude that the work done in a moving a unit test charge from infinity to the point P, or the electric potential at a point P, is V equals to W by Q naught. So from the work done we can find out the electric potential from this equation, V equals to W by Q naught. So we know the value of W, that is k q q naught upon r divided by q naught. So q naught is cancelled out. So finally we get k q upon r. Okay, so that is our electric potential at point P, work done at point P. Okay, so this is the very important theory in your exam perspective. Okay, so please write down all these stuffs. So students, our next topic is, that is the electric potential due to a dipole. Okay, so we know the dipole shape, that is it is made from the two charges, that is plus q or minus q, separated by some distance, that is 2a. okay, so this is the midpoint of the dipole. Suppose the point, it is A, here is point B. Okay, so now we want to find out the electric potential due to a dipole at the axial point of the dipole. So suppose we have one point, that is P, it is lie on dipole axis. Okay, I extend this axis. Okay, so this point, the distance between the midpoint of the dipole and this point P is suppose r. Okay, and this distance is a, this is also a. Okay, now we find out the electric potential, total electric potential due to these two charges, minus q or plus q, on point P, that is V equals to V1 plus V2. Okay, so that is the total electric potential at axial point of electric dipole P. Okay, so we want to write here V equals to V1 plus V2. Now here V1 is electric potential due to the charge minus Q on point P. Okay, and V2 is electric potential due to the charge plus Q on P. Okay, so here we know the value of or the formula of electric potential. We already derived this formula in our earlier theory. Okay, so that is came from KQ upon I. Okay, so here we can write 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught minus Q upon from this charge. Okay, so A plus R. So we can write here A to P. AP distance is AP. Then 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught plus Q, this distance or this charge. So that is PB. Okay, so now combining we can write Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught. So AP is nothing but it is the A plus R. So that is distance AP. So here you can write R plus A. Okay, then plus Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught, that is PB, it is R minus A. Okay, so here Q and 4 pi epsilon naught is constant, so that is common. So combinedly we can write Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught minus 1 upon R plus A plus 1 upon R minus A. Okay, so here we can write. Now simplify this equation, that is Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught minus 1 upon R minus A, so 1 upon R plus P. Now simplify this, so we can get now take LCM, so finally R plus A minus R minus A, that is R into R, then A into A square, and minus plus minus. Okay, now here we leave the counts, leave the bracket, then R plus A minus R plus A. Okay, that is R square minus A square. So here R and R cancel out, so finally we get the equation, that is Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2A upon R square minus A square. Okay, so that is our total electric potential due to the electric dipole on point P. So now students, here suppose for short dipole we can neglect here A square in compared to R square. So we can write here Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2A upon R square, because R square is greater than A square. Okay, because dipole is too short, that's why we can write this equation. Now we know 2A into Q, that is nothing but it is dipole. Okay, so we can write 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught P upon R square. So that is the magnitude of the electric potential. So in vector form we can write here 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught P upon R square into R cap. So R cap is nothing but it is the unit vector of the dipole. So unit vector gives the direction of the electric dipole, that is going to be minus Q to plus Q. So that is the electric dipole direction. So unit vector is nothing but it is the vector divided by its magnitude. Okay, so here we can write here 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught P, vector P and vector R divided by its magnitude. Okay, so combinedly we can write P into R upon R cube. Okay, so that is our final equation of the electric dipole for short dipole, very short dipole. Okay, and for a general normal dipole we can write here P equals to, from this equation we can write P upon, sorry, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught P upon R square minus P square. Okay, now in vector form we can also write in this way 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught P vector R to R square minus P square, and here is magnitude R.